What's up, guys? It's Chris Majestic here with Majestex, and this is going to be part 3 of the home automation series. So as I said in the other videos, I'm gonna focus this video more on SmartThings just because it can be a little bit difficult, but it is very capable. So I wanna go into these different apps to show you how you add devices and how you link the different hubs together. All right, so let's go ahead and start up the SmartThings app. The very first thing I wanna go over is some basic home automation tasks. So maybe you've already purchased, you know, some switches or bulbs or whatever you have, and you wanna know how to get these things to work. All right, so let's go ahead and go to automation. So in Good Morning, if you tap the cog there, you can see that I just have it set to turn off these lights or switches. I just have it set to turn off the master bedroom fan. So I can just tap that routine to make that happen in the morning. My wife just kind of does that, so she doesn't have to get out of the bed and turn off the fan. And secure the house away. This is basically gonna turn off everything, and it's gonna set the mode to away. And I have this set to automatically perform when everyone leaves. So if I go in here, see how it says someone arrives, everyone leaves, and all these other ones. If you go to everyone leaves, you say which. You can select which people. I have both of us set in there. That way it doesn't just do it when one of us leaves, but when both of us are gone. And then I have it delayed 1 minute. Turn off the lights is self-explanatory. That's basically just gonna turn off all the lights when it's triggered. So this is gonna be for some pretty basic stuff. Now, once you wanna get into more advanced things, that's when you're gonna start to use smart apps, because it's not only gonna be easier to do, but it's also gonna give you ideas that you may not have even thought of. So actually, let's start at the marketplace. So if you go to marketplace and you go to smart apps, you can kind of go through each of these different categories and you'll get some cool smart apps that a lot of them come from Samsung, but a lot of them are also community created. So you see how it says Michael Struck again. A lot of just random people, even though he looks like he dominates the lights and switches category. But yeah, these are just gonna be smart apps that are created by people, and they're gonna do a ton of different things. So like lights off with no motion and presence is a good example, stuff like that. You can just kind of use that smart app, install it. So it's gonna have right here how you set it up. You're just gonna put in minutes of inactivity, whatever light switches you wanna do, and then you're just gonna hit done, and it's that simple. Smart apps are definitely the bread and butter of SmartThings. So SmartThings also uses smart apps to connect to other hubs. So as you see here, I've got Amazon Alexa, I got Ift in here, Logitech Harmony is in here, the Google Assistant for Google Home is also in here. You've got Smart Lighting, which is a native smart app, very easy to use. And if you saw in part 2 of the home automation guide, I mentioned about my light switches, about the three-way setup that I have. So this basement three-way is exactly what I was saying. This three-way switch, I have it set so that which lights do you want to control? I want to control the steps light, which is at the bottom of my steps, and I want to control all of my basement lights, which is under basement lights. So I have those checked. What do I want to do? Have it turn on. Select the trigger. The trigger is just going to be the switch, since that's what it is. It says which switch is going to be the basement steps three-way, and then turn the lights on when I turn that switch on. And then you can have this checkbox here for turn off as well. That means it'll do both turn on and turn off automatically. Some other basic stuff I have in the smart lighting app is the garage light control, and this is very straightforward. These are the garage lights outside, and I have them set to turn on at sunset. And then I have them, there's a checkbox here to also turn off at sunrise, and that's pretty much it. Very simple, and I don't ever have to worry about turning my lights on or off outside. Now on to some advanced smart apps. So the SmartThings community is gonna be one of my favorite things about SmartThings. So as I mentioned, there are ways to add smart apps that don't already exist, or someone may have already come up with a way to get a device to integrate with SmartThings that Samsung themselves haven't actually done. So if that's the case, you wanna go in the community and look around. It's pretty awesome. You can do a lot of things in here, and there are some really smart and cool people in here. So you can go to devices and integrations. That's where a lot of things are. You can go on a mobile app, you can go into smart apps. This is where you're gonna find some cool smart apps. Now, I've already picked one out. So as you may not know, but the Nest Thermostat does not natively work with SmartThings. So someone, this guy here, Tonesto7, has actually made a smart app for that. So it's called the Nest Manager 4.0. It's gonna give you all the details here, show you a screenshot of how it looks. Pretty awesome. Now, these community smart apps all have different ways that you can install them. So I won't really go into how they're done, just because they all give you instructions on exactly how to do it. And that will make this video incredibly long. So Just go to the community. All of the instructions you need on how to add these smart apps to SmartThings are all there, and they have a wiki dedicated to how you do it as well. Just to give you an example, I'll just show you a couple of these here. So Rule Machine is one of the most powerful smart apps ever. So you can do pretty much anything with this app. It has access to every single device you have, and you can allow it to do whatever you want. So right here, I have kitchen light on arrival. That basically is gonna say, hey, when I get home and my garage door opens, to turn on the kitchen light. Here's another one, Cherie's garage door left open for 25 minutes. That's gonna send us a text message and a push notification that, hey, you left the garage door open. Another one's gonna be garage door open with nobody home. So that's gonna be Chris's. I have them separate, that way the push notification separate. Define the conditions is that the Z-Wave sensor is open and Chris and Cherie are not present. Select actions for true, and that's gonna be push notification. Chris garage door left open with nobody home. It's gonna send that to my number. And you can pretty much do just about anything in here, but it's a very, very powerful smart app, definitely my favorite. So Rule Machine is something I use for advanced automation, but as far as getting things to work natively that don't necessarily work with SmartThings out of the box, Total Connect is a prime example of that. So the way Total Connect works is that's basically my Honeywell alarm panel you may have seen from my other videos. So I have that set in here so that SmartThings can actually turn the alarm on. I don't have it set up for SmartThings to turn it off. I just don't trust it. I don't want to give it that much control. But the Total Connect app was created by one of the users in the community, and it basically just ties into the backend API of the online web version of the Total Connect website. So it's that simple. You just put in your login information and that's it. Whenever your mode changes to away, it's automatically going to turn the alarm on for you. So this is where SmartThings has a big edge over something like the Wink Hub, because you have these tremendous amounts of smart apps to accomplish whatever you want it to do. So there are a lot of different combinations of linking these different hubs together. Obviously, I can't show you all of them, but I do want to go through some. So the first thing I want to go over is adding the Harmony Hub to SmartThings. So first thing you're going to do is open up the SmartThings app. And you're gonna go to Marketplace over here in the corner, scroll all the way down. You're gonna see SmartThings Labs, scroll to the bottom, and there is Logitech Harmony Home Hub. Now again, it says Home Hub, but it'll apply to any Harmony Hub. Connect now, and see it gives you a note there, and then you're gonna say Harmony, click on that to enter your credentials, and it's gonna take you to the Harmony login page. So I'm gonna go ahead and put in my credentials here. Okay, so we're gonna hit done. Gonna hit next. This is where you tell SmartThings what you want Harmony to be able to control. So I'm just gonna put like all my lights in here and I'm gonna hit done. Now you notice you have a Logitech Harmony smart app here. So when you open that, it's gonna try to find your hubs. You may have to give it a minute or two to find any. Make sure if you have more than one hub, or if you do have one hub, that it's connected. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit hubs here. I have three. I'm gonna check all three of them. And then it's gonna have the activities. These are the activities for all of the hubs. So go ahead, check that. Done. Keep in mind, all those activities were already set up through the Harmony software. So if you're not sure how to do that or you got questions, you can go through the Logitech Harmony review I did. So I'm gonna go ahead and launch the Harmony software. All right, so it already automatically connected to my bedroom. I'm gonna go to menu, Harmony setup, add new devices. All right, so then you're gonna go to devices, add a device, home control, and there's SmartThings. Click SmartThings, sign in, put in your credentials, log in. Then you're gonna select your hub, so it's gonna be the home hub in my case, whatever you named yours. And then here's where you can pretty much put in whatever you want it to be able to control. So I'm just gonna let it control everything. It doesn't really matter what you choose here, it's up to you. So I'm just gonna choose it all, authorize. And that's it. So you have two different situations here. You have Harmony can control SmartThings devices, and you have SmartThings which can control your Harmony activities. So you want it to work on both ends. You may wanna do something like turn your lights off when you start an activity. That's all gonna be done in the Harmony app, since you can see the lights from SmartThings in the app. So you can just add that to your Harmony activities. So the next thing I wanna show you is how to add SmartThings to Google Home if you have a Google Home. So the first thing you're gonna do is launch the Google Home app. go to the menu, home control. If you have devices in there, they'll already show up, but we're gonna hit the plus sign to add a device. Tap SmartThings. It's gonna pull up the SmartThings API just like it did for Harmony. And then you're gonna choose everything you want it to access right here. And I'm gonna tap authorize. All right, it's syncing. And it looks like, all right, now it wants to assign it to rooms. You can go ahead and assign it to rooms however you want, but you would just tap on each device and assign it to whatever room you think it should go in. I'm gonna skip that for now. So I'm gonna hit done. So I hit got it, and that's pretty much it. So now you can just control all of your SmartThings devices right from Google Home. So considering Google Home doesn't work directly with Harmony, if you have a SmartThings hub, you can obviously, as you can see, you can use it to control your Harmony activities. So you don't necessarily need them to communicate directly. Since all of your Harmony activities are listed as SmartThings switches, you can just tell Google Home to turn on the TV and it's gonna trigger that Harmony activity to start and your TV will turn on. Same thing with turning it off. All right, so since we're still on SmartThings now, I'm gonna show you how to add SmartThings to Alexa. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is go ahead and fire up the Alexa app. And once it loads, we're gonna hit the menu. You're gonna hit skills. Since we're gonna be adding the SmartThings skill, you can see you have your skills up here, but what I'm gonna do is go ahead and search SmartThings. Search, there it is, tap on that, enable skill. You're gonna put in your SmartThings credentials here. Go ahead and log in, and then just like you did on the other apps, you're gonna choose whatever hub you want. This checkbox is gonna allow it to connect to your devices and routines. So then I'm gonna hit authorize, and that's it. So once you have Alexa discover devices, that's gonna be done. The next thing we wanna do is add Harmony to Alexa. So we're gonna search for that skill as well. So let's go ahead and type in Harmony. There's the Harmony app, enable skill. It's gonna ask us to log into the Harmony servers. So unfortunately right now, Alexa only allows you to connect to one Harmony hub at a time, which sucks. But there is a workaround for this if you have SmartThings. So let's go ahead and get through this and then I'll show you what I mean. So for now, I'm just gonna choose my living room because that's the hub that I use the most. And this is where you can choose whatever your friendly names are gonna be. So if you've got like your wife or whoever in the house that wants to name one of these activities something differently, so you can say pretty much whatever you want to trigger that activity. So you're gonna go to next. And this is where you're gonna see all of your favorites here. So this is definitely helpful because you can just tell Alexa to turn on whatever this channel is or whatever your favorite is. You can add a friendly name for that too. And it's gonna turn to that channel. So that's definitely awesome. So we're gonna go to next and then we're gonna link the accounts and then that's it. So if you have Harmony, Alexa, and SmartThings, you can actually control more than one hub at a time with your voice, even though the Alexa app only supports one hub. Now, unfortunately, when it comes down to favorite channels, that is something that you can only do with one hub at a time, since that is the Alexa app going directly to the hub. But as far as all your other activities, since you have those activities in SmartThings and they're just listed as switches, once you add all of your switches and everything from the SmartThings app into the Alexa app, you're gonna have all your activities there. So you can just tell Alexa, turn on my living room TV, and then SmartThings is gonna talk to the Harmony Hub and the Harmony Hub is gonna do it. So that's kind of a cool workaround. There is really no downside to that. But unfortunately, if you don't have a SmartThings Hub and all you have is Alexa and the Harmony Hub, you can't do that. So another thing I wanna briefly go over is a tablet that I have on my wall near the kitchen. And this is a basic Amazon Fire tablet and I have it connected to my wall using 3M locking strips. So if you look here, you can just pop it off the wall. So it's basically just gonna use the same strips that you usually would find for like an easy pass in your car. So they just simply kind of lock onto each other so you can just pop it on and off the wall like that. All right, so this is gonna be really straightforward. I just obviously have the weather here. This is the SmartThings widget. So I have my routines and automation right in there. Obviously you see all the smart apps I have here. And then I have my daughter's camera, like a baby monitor camera right there. So it's pretty self-explanatory. Like I have Harmony here, I can just open it up. Since I'm near the living room, I can just go ahead and trigger one of the living room activities from right here. And then if I need to, I have a charger right here that I can just plug into the side of it if I want to. All right, guys, so that's gonna be it for this video. Again, this is the last video of the home automation series. If you haven't already, go back and watch part one and part two. If you found it helpful, go ahead and hit that thumbs up for me. I do wanna hear your questions and comments, so go ahead and post in the comments section. I'll respond to your questions, and I'll see you guys in the next video.